Greetings everyone, this is Ring, and here we are with our Porsche 356A Speedster, Super Speedster as a matter of fact, which is currently a bit fucked. Well, we won't repair it because not enough money basically. Ooh, oh, so many cool 356s and 356As. Oh, I want a 356 Super Cabriolet, but I don't have enough money. I'm gonna get one as soon as I can. I want it so bad. I mean, I could probably... How much would I get? Let me see how much it cost me to repair it. Wait, why can't I repair it? Okay, but... Why... I'll just repair all these. Fix... That's odd, it should've just... Let me fix it. And I'm going to go in the used car. I'm gonna... What am I selling? Okay. I'm gonna sell my 356. Please enter the offer price for the car. 10,500. Is it gonna sell now? Because I want this thing. A 1500 Super Cabriolet. A 50... I want to go as early as I can. Oh, it's a 1300. This is a 1500. Oh, that's pretty pricey, isn't it? Well, I'm gonna get one regardless. I'm gonna get one as soon as I can because my bulk standard 356 11. No, you know what? No, I need to keep. I want to keep my 1100. It's the first one. It's the first one. It's a 50. It's from 1950. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna keep the 356. And we need a B now. It's 1960. And we need a B. Super. Okay, so. Is there a speedster? No, there is no such thing as a speedster. It needs to be a super. If it's not a super, then it has no swag to it. It needs to be a 13500 Super 1600 Super 90 Roadster. Because that just sounds cool, doesn't it? Or do I want a hard top? That's the question. You know what? It's not all about money. I'm gonna get a hard top for a change. Screw it. I want a hard top for a change. Hang on. Is there a price difference? Okay, the super hard top is more expensive. You know what? I'm gonna get a hard top. I want something for a change, and I'm gonna get it in bright ass blue. There we go. This thing is pretty. Also, okay, this is an upper class. There's some modifications to it. How about that? I'm sorry, I shouldn't. Let's go for. I want to get. Do I want slicks? I don't want slicks. I want more horsepower. That's all I need. So, medium performance carbs. And a low restriction exhaust system. Let's get those on our list. Hopefully that won't make it too fast, because that'll be a bit of a disappointment. So car setup, install medium performance carbs. Okay, and then go to my parts inventory and sell the old parts, because I frankly don't need them and I need the money. Now we have a faster, good looking 356 B. I don't like the rear on the 356 B. I think the rear is butt ugly. It's literally butt ugly. Okay. Let's. Ooh. Our roaring 356. With new carburetors. Finally, two new carburetors at that. Ooh, look at that clunk. Ooh, this thing is fucking fast! Christ! I was not expecting that from this puny 356. I think it is 0 to 60 in like 7-ish seconds or something like that. Oh, whoa! Okay, maybe I should have done some suspension upgrades to it as a second thought. Don't break it, it's an insurance. It's an endurance race. So I shall not break it. because if I do, that'll be very expensive. What? That'll cost me more in the race. Oh my! Did I just save that? Oh my god, that has to be the greatest save ever. How did I just say that? By the way, this game sometimes lags. I don't know why. I have SLI 970s. Give me a break, game. How the fuck did I manage to save that? That was blind luck. That was pure fucking luck. Whoa! God fucking damn it. Yeah, thank you, game. I know I'm pointing the wrong goddamn way. Come on, the little blue 356B. The game has a bit of a steering assist, which I don't mind, to be honest. I want a keyboard. Okay, it's not that bad. It just kind of like slightly curves the steering wheel, and I've never really minded. I think I removed it actually my first playthrough, but I don't mind it that much now. I mean, if I notice it really takes effect, like now, like it would have started steering for me, then yeah. Look, it does steer a little bit, but you can't pass this then with the steering it gives you. It's basically just so when you're reverting in a normal position, doesn't twitch the car. I actually think that's a really smart thing. I have actually never realized it. I never realized why it existed. It was some sort of steering assist, but no, it's just, hey, you have a keyboard. Let's help you a little. Let's give you a hand. Otherwise, this shit will happen. Ooh, saved it. Going to a fish market. Hey, you ladies. I get it because it smells like fish. Okay. Whoa. Super 90. I like the names. Speedster. Super 90. It's great. Super 90 hardtop. It's this game is so, this game just the 60s and 50s. I'm a sucker for the 60s. The 60s was a weird time to be alive in, which I wasn't obviously, but it was like the Vietnam War, the JFK getting killed, the muscle car era, Jimi Hendrix dying and existing actually, because he was only a 60s thing. The hippies, then in the early 70s the smog stuff, and all of those is just pretty insane. I sometimes wish I would have been alive back then, but then again, I wouldn't wish I was alive in Romania back then. No, I fucking didn't, because 60s Romania, we didn't have cars because we still haven't had a Dacia back then. We were still we're very, very communist still. TV was not much of a thing. Yeah, there's just so many problems. It's just, Romania, 60s, not a nice time to be alive in. But America, 60s, it's a pretty, I mean, I still like the 2010s more. 2000s, just, I'm a millennial and it'll start for me. You won the race. It'd be hard for me to live without anything such as my PC. But then again, of entertainment, I actually really enjoy books, so I'm not that desperate, but a P-R-N-A. Okay, so I can't, I don't get it. It's not broken anyway, it'll do. It will have to do, because I am not that. My 356 is fixed, my...
3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, see, at the start of this you can see clearly the small steering assist. But it doesn't help me that much. Like, look, I'm going straight. I'll go straight into that wall, see? It can't. You know what? I don't like this shortcut. I'm gonna do it anyway. No. Ah! That was wall tap. That was a big fat wall tap. Back on the power, come on. Yep, that's why I don't like the shortcut. It's risky and you don't get that much of a lead. But I took it already, so. Yeah, so all the races, I think all of the races are sprints in this game. I think so. Just the tracks are so memorable. Still, the one that stuck with me the most is probably Normandy and Côte d'Azur. Those are probably the ones that stuck with me. That marked me in some regards. Like, whenever I see a track in a game, it has to live up to that standard. It's basically that good. Just has to live up to that standard. And whenever I see police chases in a game, they have to live up to NFS Most Wanted. I don't care about the NFS purists that don't like Black Box, because yes, they do exist. They do exist. People that there are people that think NFS Porsche 2000 was their last great game, which it wasn't. That's called Pro Street. Pro Street was good. I don't care what you say, what anyone says. Pro Street was good. Wasn't great. It was good. I'd play it. I have no issues playing it. I finished it. I finished all NFS games of Iron Undercover. I finished Shift 1, Shift 2. I guess I'm really near completion. I think I might have reinstalled my Windows once. I don't think I have my save anymore, but I was really near completion. I did a lot of like unnecessary things. I had a bunch of money and a bunch of cars and all that jazz. So I can say I've finished it. I haven't finished all events. There's no story ending to that game, basically. I did the drag racing, the drifting, the everything. It's good, but yeah, it was NFS Shift 2, I believe it's a great game. So, same for Shift 1, even though people don't really like them, I like them. Hot Pursuit, that one is, none of the Hot Pursuit games, none of the three Hot Pursuit games, never finished any of those. So, The Run I finished, Carbon I speedran, you can find my Twitch, I have the stream saved. Yes, I've speedrun underground. Carbon. Then I finished Most Wanted the first time on my own, because I finished it with my cousin when I was younger. I finished it the first time on my own this year, completely on my own. And this year, like a week ago maybe, I don't know, but it was so good. That game is good. It's not good. It's the best, the greatest. Not the modifications, how the cars handled. Every car was in its own regards different. Okay, when I went from my Lotus, from a Mercedes, you could feel the weight of it. And then I went to my Clio, and that thing was a fucking missile. It's just nothing. I have been rudely interrupted by this guy. But yeah, like, you could feel the difference, and some cars were worse in chases, better in chases, but they were battle race. Yeah, all those things. The customization was alright, but I don't care much about customization. I like customizing my cars, in some regard. I don't like outside customizing your car. I keep yawning. A game that I really wish I would have played was NFS, what was the name of it? NFS. I think Rest of 6K. Oh my god. I actually don't know the name of it. Motor City. Motor City, there we go. Motor City Online. I would have loved that game if I would have played it. But it shut down long. Wow! It might have been up when I could still use a computer, like when I was young, but that game was a subscription-based game. My dad would have killed me. Plus, I didn't know about it. It was a really American game. It was a very American game. And you could build your cars from the ground up and auction. Oh my god, that game was so good. I've never played it, but I know it was good. It just, the driving was like an NFS High Stakes, which is great. I've played High Stakes the first time the other day. Because I've never played, but now I have. Like I can say, it's great. The handling model. But you could build cars, and you had the social aspect. Oh my god, it just completely smashed my car. you had the social aspect of NFS World with elder microtransactions and with way better sync. I mean, look, it was good for 2003. It was good sync, goodish sync. The netcode in the world was just a mess. It's a good netcode. I mean, look, some people played on a 56k router. I would so much rather have a subscription-based game than a pay-to-win NFS World. Because, look, if it's a free game, people will just make accounts. They'll hack and make accounts. Fuck, I hacked. I've hacked like... What did I do? I think... Let me remember. I don't know. I think I've hacked some sort of like... I had some sort of money trick thingy majiggle. It was like an exploit or something of that sort. And they've used it, and I remember I had a lot of money. I can't remember how I did it for the life of me. I think I traded accounts? I don't know. It was a long time ago. But regardless of that, it's just that... That game had the potential to be good. It had black box handling with NFS carbon and most wanted maps, with customization of the Wazoo, an amazing card selection, and somehow it failed because microtransactions, no anti-cheat, and the game was free to play, so every hacker could just whoop right in. I don't like free to play games. I don't have a lot of money. I can get like max of one game a month, or maybe two, with my allowance, and that's it. It's like, I'm fine, you know, one game a month, I'm alright, I'll survive. I play older games all the time, and I play MTA and BeamNG Drive. I have 170 hours on it. Well, lift off of Steam, and fucking, I'm so salty that NFS World flopped. I am so salty. I wanted it. It used to be good. It used to not be pay to win. It used to don't have that many cheaters. Then the cheaters started. They started putting microtransactions up their ass. It just became a mess. It really did. I remember I had like a Nissan 200 SX, an S4. No, I had an S13. I remember. And no one wanted S13. No one had S13. Everyone had S14. Or anything else but S13. And I had S13 and I whooped ass with it. Oh my god, I'm getting nostalgia now. I miss that game of sorts. I mean, it was a fun time. It didn't last very long because I got salty about the fucking... Salty, I got mad over the microtransactions. It didn't last very long, but I liked it. It was fun. It was NFS multiplayer with bad sync, but...
You've won the race!
Yes, I have, thank you. I think I've won the tournament. I hope I've won the tournament. Let's peruse. Alright, we have won the tournament. Okay, so let me give you a little tip. Rank top tips. Hang on, used cars, let's see what we have here. Well, I can't find any non... Oh, there's... should I pull the trigger on this? You know what? I'll see. I'll see. So what you do is you go to new cars, and the only two cars is the 911 Coupe and 356 Carrera 356B Carrera 2. What you don't do is you don't get the 911 because you see the 911 isn't worth shit. And it handles absolutely terribly. It is a death trap. So you get a 356B, which handles much better. It will have way more value in the future because they're extremely rare and desirable as of now as well. And it's faster because it's a well-worn chassis, to say the least. Okay, so let's buy this. Well, warning is a very good term to use. And my car has raised in value. It's not worth more than I pay for it. See? That's how it works. Let's see. I have enough money to fix some of my cars. The speedster's still broken. I need to fix it. At least the body. The body's what pisses me off. I don't like having a messed up body. How the fuck did I damage some tires? I mean, you either punch at them or wear them out. There's no middle ground. Okay, the Super 90 hardtop. This thing has a little bit of damage. I don't know why I can't just press outright, just fix, but I can't. So I need to do this all the time. And now all of my cars are in showroom condition. I'm drinking some soda. Some pop. See what I can do to this thing. Parts. Right now I don't have a car for long enough to want to modify it. Low restriction exhaust. No, I need rims. I want rims. I actually really want rims. Come on, rims. So what I'm gonna do is get a bumper upgrade. Fiberglass hood, quarter panels, let's see. I don't wanna break the bank. Sport shocks, semi-sport springs. And that's it. I got plenty of power. I just need some handling. That's all. Parts. Right. No, I don't want it. Fuck's sake. How did I install them? Was it? I think it was car setup, wasn't it? Okay, yes. It's now lighter, faster, and nimbler. If that's even a term. I mean, I could get slicks and make it way better. Okay, I have no clue what the bumper upgrade is. You know what? It's Gucci Manucci. I hate it. I hate the term Gucci. I'm going to buy slicks. Not rain tires. Okay, yeah, it's either slicks or nothing. So I'm gonna get slicks. I might regret it. We'll see. Hopefully it's gonna handle good on slicks. I hope it will. Okay. Now we'll go racing. At this point, but new tracks will be introduced in soon.
3, 2, 1, go!
What's the thing? This thing. Wow, this thing is grippy. It's fast. It's quite fast, actually. Yeah, it's like the speedo goes up to 250 km/h. So it must be fast. Oh my god, this thing is tight as a drum. Whoa, no, fuck! Okay, that was... Okay, does it still drive straight? Ish. Okay, yes it does. I think it has less power, but... You know what? That'll do. I'm fine with that. I'll have to live with it. Oh my god. Don't break it too hard, Alex. Yeah, the 911s have a hard time, as you can see, and there goes my nimble 356. The thing is, no one bought the 356 Carrera because the 911 was out. So absolutely no one got the Carrera 356, and now they are worth hundreds of thousands. While the early 911s are probably knocking on the six figure as well, but they aren't that high up as the 356 Carrera 2. The early 911s had problems, to say the least. The very early ones, such as this one. But this is the last 356. So I guess it is goodbye to the 356s after... Oh, a couple of more races. Well, see, that guy just got 911'd. Did you see it? Did you see the rearview mirror? He got... Oh my god, he recovered it. Wow, Dylan. You are impressing me. Jesus, that was a save and a half. I love how the attack goes up to like 8 grand, but then it kind of like runs out of lines. It's pretty funny. It like runs out of lines at like 75. That was team speak, which I shall turn off soonish, because I forgot it all. This thing is, it's fun, but it doesn't want to kill you because it's on slicks. As you can see, the game becomes more difficult. They're actually on my tail now. See that out on my car is really bad. I think this car is slower than the other 356. To be honest, I really think that. I think it's pretty dog piss. Like, we're just struggling at 100 miles an hour. Cock, that was understeer city. Okay, yeah, the car is slower now. It's not revving as fast. So I need to have a lift. Okay, I'll have to fix that whole backside. How badly is it wounded? It's pretty poor, but I've done worse. I've definitely done worse.
You place first.
The 96. I remember when that was considered a cool car. That was a long time ago. Fix. Okay, my engine was indeed a bit damaged. Oh no, my bumper upgrade won. My fiberglass quarter panels, my slicks. Wow, that's a expensive repair bill. Okay, hang on. Okay, now the thing as steam speak in my background. I want to go to sleep, but it's only 8:30. I don't know why. Maybe because I've been to like school and stuff like that, but I'm just terribly tired. Okay, so try to not crash so I don't have an expensive repair bill. I'm now in first, so it should be pretty easy. Okay, now you see, now we're fast, now we're moving. Okay, so if I lift, the rear end comes back around, which is what I want. I want my rear end loose-ish. Not this loose. Back on the power. Whoa. Saved it. Okay, so yeah, don't lift too much. Just lift a little bit. Then get back on the... Okay, noted. So, I now know how to drive a Porsche. Don't lift. Ever. Don't lift and inertia will be nice to you. Yeah, you see, even when I had a small lift and I got back into it, still wanted to play a little earthy. It's, oh my god, the handling of this game is amazing. Whoa! I wasn't expecting it to turn in like that. Fuck. That was a bad bump. I was not... Why did it turn in like that? Jesus. It turned in hard. It like gripped and I'm not used to... Okay, I need to stop using slicks. I think they're too grippy for me. I'm expecting something else of the car and then just grips. Get out of my way, bitch, and your slow ass 911 Carrera 356 power. You bitch ass chigger. God fucking damn it. That was some more damage. The car drives semi straight. Okay, I know I'm approaching. I'm somewhat approaching the end of this race and I need to win. Oh, there we go. He got 911. I got 356. Okay, I think my motor is hurting a little. come on, stop on the sting, stop on the sting, stop on the sting. Oh my god, the understeer. Jesus. It's awful. Dylan and his red 911. Come on, Dylan. Not Dylan. Paris? Get the f... Oh my god, I'm losing. I'm slow. I'm very slow. Okay. I can only outhandle them. I, however, cannot outrun them. Maybe I shouldn't have taken this shortcut. No. Okay, saved it. Fucking hell. This is twisty. Oh, Dylan lost it, come on. I know that the finish is just around this bend. Fuck you, Dylan. Just fuck you, prick. Barely. This prick. He barely inched me, I swear. Dick. Okay, it's now Côte d'Azur, yeah. No, it's Normandy. Excuse me. Why can't I just press fix? That pisses me off. Oh, now I get it. Oh, I'll just press overall. Ah, that just made my life so much easier. How did I... Why didn't I figure that out till now? Okay, here is my green 356. Pardon me. Okay, so I don't think it's a reverse Côte d'Azur. Okay, I think I need to take a right somewhere here. Oh my god. Don't crash it, don't... I just did. Alex, you stupid knob. Yes, I did just talk to myself. Look at that guy! Steal, you prick. Jesus. I remember when I was playing it, oh my god, in my first playthrough, right? I had a problem-ish, but my car was too fast. I like a 911, the thing was too fucking fast. I'm having the same problem with this thing, it's too fast. It's too... handling focus, rather. And I am not expecting it to do the things it does. It understeers when you don't want it to. And it doesn't understeer when you're expecting it to. And that's when you crash, because you turn in too hard. Because you're expecting it to just shit itself. See? Like that. I was expecting it to just go shit bricks. Well... saved it. Oh, I need new pants. Look, there's a guy doing stuff. I've actually never seen that person. Wow. He looks fucking creepy. Because the graphics are really not about the character models. I'm still yawning. It's all like European sceneries and stuff, which I probably miss some European stuff when I'm moving to the US, but... Whoa, fuck! You know what I'll miss? My time zone. GMT plus one is pretty good. The GMT plus two, excuse me, is pretty nice. But then again, I actually usually stay all night because I want to speak to my American friends. Oh, I accidentally crashed Dylan's car. I crashed into Dylan. It's just a clunk. This is the world's loudest transmission. Just clunk. Hog. It's into gear.
Into gear we go.
Okay, after this race will be the end of this. Will be the goodbye 356 episode. This is the Carrera 2 is the 356 Swan song, and it's fucking awful. But then again, the 911 is even worse. So I actually like I forgot how bad the 911 is. So that's why I think this is bad. But the 911 is fucking worse. It's the fucking worst thing ever. And the 65, the 67 got a little better. Fuck you, Dylan. Beat ya, bitch. Wow, there's someone that's like 2 minutes behind. Jesus. Where the fuck was he 2 minutes behind? How slow are you going, fam? Now. Anyway. Yes, this is. Let's repair it. As this is our last ever 356. So yeah, thank you for watching the second episode of this, and I will see you next time.